What's up, my YouTube family? Sergeant Greybeard with the Gaming Brigade back with another Division 2 video. Today is Monday, July 12th, and as always, I hope this message finds you healthy and safe. As most of you know by now, unfortunately, there hasn't been really any official news from the Division in a while. However, every Monday, I typically like to go over some of the feedback you've sent the channel over the last week, you know, in regards to your gameplay, things like that, and also try to answer any questions that you happen to send the channel. Now, if you happen to be new here, first of all, welcome. Secondly, feel free to hit that subscribe button. We would love for you to be a part of our gaming family. And if you enjoyed this or found it helpful at all, take a quick second and hit that like button. It really does help us out. Finally, as most of you know, we have giveaways here, and our current one is for a $100 gift card to either Xbox, PlayStation, or Steam, depending on which platform you're on. And all you need to do to enter is either subscribe here or follow us on Twitter. Either way is fine. We will be announcing the winner on August 1st of this year, and as I've mentioned in every previous video, please keep in mind that watching our content is not a requirement to win. Only watch the things here you may enjoy. That's why you have the option of entering via Twitter. Having said that, let's get into today's video. So the first thing I'd like to talk about today, my friends, are the issues that some gamers are having in regards to finding a group in the game, whether it's for the summit or a mission or a bounty, and the wait times that they're encountering as they're trying to just find someone to play with. Now, most of the people that have reached out to me have been playing on PC. Now, I don't know if this is happening for console players. I can say from my personal gameplay, I've had no issues. I mean, typically within like 15, 20 seconds, I'm in a group, no problem. So there happen to be a few different methods that I use depending on what I'm trying to do in the game. So let's say, for instance, if I don't care what mission I run, I'm just worried about the difficulty, all I do is go to random matchmaking, I choose a difficulty, and you'll see here something does pop up pretty quick. I have noticed, however, if I'm trying to matchmake for a specific mission, that's where sometimes I will encounter wait time. So what I do is this. I typically start the mission, call for backup, and usually within 3 minutes, I'll have a full group. Now, when it comes to matchmaking for the summit, what I recommend to do is this. You know, go to your map while you're in DC, go over to matchmaking, pick the difficulty that you want to do, and for some reason, and this I've actually heard from a lot of people as well, this seems to really speed up the process. And once again, from my own personal gameplay, I know for me, you know, if I go to the summit itself and I go into the lobby, go up the stairs, go to that little computer that says matchmake, I sometimes seem to be there for 3, 4, 5, 6 minutes with no response. So this method seems to work really well. And as we move on, my friends, please let me know in the comment section down below, first of all, if you've been having this issue, but secondly, if you have any tips or tricks you want to pass along to other players. You guys know the main focus at this channel is to help out in any way we can. Next, I'd like to talk about game crashing, delta errors, and things of that nature. And recently, I've been hearing from a bunch of different people saying that in New York, for some reason, there have been a bunch of different missions that have been completely bugging out. And once again, unfortunately, one of those is Liberty Island. The issue that's been brought to my attention recently is that when players are getting to the point in the mission where they face the Marauder, Marauder? Is that the word, Marauder? I'm just going to keep repeating it. Anyway, whatever. The point is, when they get there, they're immediately disconnected. Now, in full transparency, I really do not set foot in New York that often. Most of my favorite missions happen to be in DC. I do like Wall Street because you're facing four named bosses. But the point is this, I have not played Liberty Island in a while, so I have not seen this take place. However, if you are having this issue, please let me know in the comment section down below. Moving on, my friends, I'd now like to talk about directives, as some of you have reached out to the channel recently wondering how beneficial is it to actually have them activated when you're playing, because as we all know, it can greatly, you know, change the manner in which you play the game, and a lot of people are wondering, is it really worth your time? Now, when it comes to farming XP, they are without a doubt beneficial, because every time you activate a directive, you're getting a 25% bonus to that XP gain, which is great, and that really holds true especially for people who are new to the game, you're trying to get over Shade level 1000, or you're really trying to speed up your seasonal progress. With that being said, most people are not too concerned about XP right now. They'd much rather focus on getting those god-rolled items and gear. Now, from my experience, I've gotten most of my god-rolled items from named enemies, you know, rogue agents of the open world. However, I have heard from so many different agents saying, you know, running control points and missions with four directives active is the only way to go. Same thing within the summit. Now, I'm actually in the process of doing a comparison video, and that should be out this week. Hopefully that should give you an idea of some sort of a baseline you can expect when you're adding directives, whether it's in the open world of the summit, how many you add, you know, what a big change that makes, if any. And again, you know, always remember it's RNG. There are going to be some good sessions and other ones are just going to be a hot mess. As always, my friends, do me a favor and let me know what's going on with your gameplay down below. You know, how are you finding the best items and gear and all that stuff in the game? Are you playing solo, in a group, directives, no directives, you know, summit, missions, whatever it is? As most of you know, as I've said before, we want to try to help each other out in any way we can. Finally, my friends, I'd like to talk about Dark Zone exclusive items, as many of you have reached out to the channel recently saying that you really wish these items were in the open world. Now, I don't think that's going to change anytime soon. However, we do start a new global event this week, not a new one, it's a repeat, but the point is, for those of you that want to get those Dark Zone exclusive items without setting foot in the Dark Zone, this is the time to do it. One of the best things about the global event, in my opinion, is that you have the opportunity to gain stars. And with those stars, you can then purchase named caches and I think legacy caches as well. And both of those can have Dark Zone exclusive items in there. Now tomorrow, and this will be in addition to my vendor reset, I will also be putting together a dedicated video showing new returning players, you know, whatever it may be, how to gain stars as quickly as possible so you can really stack up on things you may be missing. With all that being said, my friends, I'm going to start to wrap this video up. However, as always, I want to take a moment and thank you all for your continued support and remind you, if you have any questions or comments or feedback, please let me know in the comment section down below. It's going to be a pretty busy week at the channel. I'm going to be doing, as I mentioned, tomorrow's vendor reset, then a dedicated video on trying to farm for stars. And then on Wednesday, we have Cassie Mendoza and another farming video, then a build video, and just a bunch of different things, my friends. So again, thank you so much for being a part of this family, taking the time and watching this content. Like I mentioned at the beginning of this thing, if you happen to be new here, feel free to hit that subscribe button. We would love for you to be a part of our gaming family. If you enjoyed this, feel free to hit that like button as well. But most importantly, take care of yourselves, be kind to each other, and we will talk to you soon. Thanks again, everyone.
Supply room access unlocked.